the White House is now past the point where it can delay punitive action against Iran much longer. The most likely military option would be to put a blockade on the Persian Gulf, an act that would cut off Iranian oil exports. George Bush was in Marquette briefly this morning, accompanied by Governor Milliken during a five-day campaign swing through Michigan. He spoke to Don Ryan of Cleveland Cliffs Iron Company about the economic situation of the Upper Peninsula and about the threat of foreign imports to the iron ore and steel industries. Bush then held a short press conference on the lakeshore near the ore docks of the Upper Harbor. When asked how he viewed the viability of his campaign, Bush responded with optimism and enthusiasm.
"It's great. I wish I had more delegates, and I wish I had more time. But I'm in it to stay. 49% of the delegates in Detroit are non-committed, legally. There's plenty of room for the same kinds of shifts to take place in 80 that took place in 76.
The remains of the 8 U.S. servicemen who died on the ill-fated Iranian hostage rescue mission are on their way to the United States. The bodies were flown to Zurich earlier in the day from Tehran. They were then turned over to the U.S. ambassador in an airport ceremony. The sealed coffins, totaling 9 because Iran insists 9 Americans died in the raid, were then placed on a U.S. Air Force transport for the flight to Dover Air Force Base in Delaware.